I am the flag of the United States of America. I am whatever you make me, nothing more. I am your belief in yourself, your dream of what people may become. I live a challenging life, a life of moods and passions, of heartbreaks and tired muscles. Sometimes I droop, for then purpose has gone for me, and cynically I play the coward. But always, I am all that you hope to be, and have the courage to try for. I am song and fear, struggle and panic, and enabling hope. I am the days of work of the weakest man, and the largest dream of the most daring. I am the farmer, the lawyer, doctor, cook, counselor, and clerk. I am the battle of yesterday and the mistake of tomorrow. I am the mystery of men who do without knowing why. I am the clutch of an idea and the reason purpose of resolution. I am no more than what you believe me to be and all that you believe that I can be. I am what you make me, nothing more. I wave before your eyes as a bright gleam of color, a symbol of yourself, the pictured suggestion of that big thing which makes this nation. My stars and stripes as you dream of labors. They are bright with color, brilliant with courage, and firm with faith, because you have made them out of so in your heart. And as long as men cherish liberty more than life itself, I shall continue to be the enduring banner of the United States. I am the flag of the great Lone Star State of Texas. When Texans look upon me, names such as Austin, Houston, Travis, Bannon, Bowie, and Crockett flash through their memories. They think of the landmarks of Texas liberty, Goliad, San Jacinto, and the Alamo. I represent grazing cattle, fruit-laden orchards, green fields of grain, and brightly painted barns. It was me that Colonel Bannon was speaking of when he said, "Give us the flag for which we can fight and hoist up in defiance of Santa Ana." My vertical line of blue stands for the loyalty in the hearts of all Texans. My horizontal stripe of white stands for the purity in the hearts of all Texans. My horizontal stripe of red represents the blood that has been shed by Texans everywhere in the name of freedom and liberty. A star has always been a symbol of domination and sovereignty, and it is only proper that I should bear a star as a symbol of the Lone Star State of Texas. I represent many things to many people. I can be all that you make me, but nothing more. And as long as men cherish liberty and freedom, I shall continue to fly proudly over the free state of Texas.
Thank you.
Texas flag. I pledge allegiance to the Texas, one state under God, one and indivisible. Please bow your head with me as we pray. Dear Lord, we thank you for this day and thank you for allowing us to be here today to live another day for you and your glory. I just want to thank you for everyone that got to make it today and to be able to honor these veterans who have served this country. I pray for families that may have fallen loved ones that serve for our country. I thank you for allowing everyone to make it here safely, and I pray for safe travels home. We love you, and we thank you for all that you've done for us. In your name we pray, amen. You may now be seated.
Thank you. We are so honored to be here today and honor the men and women that served our country in the military. A life of military service means hard work, courage, and sacrifice. Our guest speaker for today is a veteran that knows all about military commitment. Mr. John Allen enlisted in the United States Marine Corps in July of 1995 after graduation. He served an impressive 27 years and retired in July of 2022. Please help me welcome Mr. Allen.
Good morning, Cayuga. All right, I'd like to thank you all for your continued support in actively recognizing veterans with an assembly of teachers and students K through 12. I know that not all schools recognize Veterans Day like this, and I would like to thank your principal, Mr. Thompson, who is also an Army veteran, and the teachers for creating a culture that takes time out of our school day to recognize those that are here in our community today. Those that you call your moms and dads, your uncles, aunts, sisters, brothers, cousins, those that all sit before you today as United States Armed Forces veterans. Every day, our brave troops face unimaginable challenges on the front lines, putting their lives on the line to protect our freedoms and uphold peace, to make tremendous sacrifices, leaving their families behind in enduring grueling conditions. Like the Vice President back there said, my name is John Allen, and I'm a United States Marine, and I've served for 27 years. I'm honored to have been asked to come and speak with you all today. I was told that I have about an hour to talk, so I'll try to keep it short. Okay, I was just kidding. I'll be brief. But as I'm sure that most vets here today, we can tell stories for hours about our exploits in the military. I grew up just down the road north of Bradford. I know some of your moms and dads, and I guess now I'm old enough to say some of your grandparents. I attended Cayuga High School my freshman year before returning to Athens High School, where I graduated in 1995 and shipped off to Marine Corps boot camp shortly thereafter. Many of you may wonder what it's like to be in the military. I'll explain in terms of sports, since I know many of you have played or will play some type of sport in your time. Military-like sports takes teamwork, brotherhood, accountability, that all ties back to discipline. Teamwork. You do your job for your teammate to the left and right. Because if I do mine and you do yours, we'll be all right. Brotherhood. What that means to me is I'm going to do what I must do to take care of my brothers and sisters on the field. Because I have love for them, I'm going to do everything I can to do better because I know what cloth you're cut and what you'll do for me. Accountability. You hold yourself accountable and you hold your teammates accountable. Because if you aren't doing what you're supposed to do and not where you're supposed to be, then you must be there. And sometimes you must just take a hard look at yourself in the mirror and say, I must do better. So just do it. Those enemies, both foreign and domestic, that's my enemy. And I'm going to do everything I can to take the time, when the time comes, to meet on that battlefield. I'm going to come back with a win with all my brothers and sisters. It should be the same concept for you in sports or any competition. I hope that makes sense. So my first year in the Marine Corps wasn't very exciting for me in San Diego, California, so I volunteered to serve on American embassy duty to protect Americans' classified material and interests overseas. I served as an embassy guard in Algiers, Algeria, and Northern Africa, in Budapest, Hungary, in Europe, and Bishkek, Kyrgyzstan, which is part of the former Soviet Union. Upon my completion of embassy duty and serving overseas, I still wanted to do and see more, so I again volunteered to go overseas and was sent to Okinawa, Japan. While in Okinawa, Japan, I deployed to East Timor, which is a small country between Indonesia and Australia, on a peacekeeping and humanitarian mission. Soon after returning back from East Timor to Okinawa, Japan, the United States was attacked on 9/11. The military changed for everyone that day. We were no longer a peacetime military. We were at war. At the time, those of us in Japan were not going to get the opportunity and chance to go to war, so I volunteered again to go back to embassy duty where I served in Bamako, Mali, West Africa, and Dahran, Saudi Arabia, in the Middle East. Upon completion of embassy duty, I requested to be sent to a unit, the first unit or the next unit, deploying to Iraq, and I was granted that opportunity. So, in Iraq, I served as a vehicle commander, and for incident response team, for EOD, and for forward operating bases. And sticking to my country roots, our call sign was John Deere. So when I returned from Iraq, I received orders to join forces in Naples, Italy. In Naples, Italy, I deployed several more times to both Iraq and Afghanistan. After 14 years of being overseas, I was assigned to Marine Special Operations Command in North Carolina, where I was a program manager and oversaw multi-purpose canines. These canines were deployed with their handles in many Marine Special Operations teams throughout the world. This position also continuously had me traveling across the U.S. and overseas to many countries in Europe and multiple times to Israel. My 20 years of military service had quickly approached, and I was able to retire and come back home to Texas. But I was given yet another opportunity that kept me serving in the military. This opportunity was to serve as the security chief for Presidential Helicopter Squadron 1, also known as HMS 1. I'm going to tell you all this not because, you know, I'm proud of what I've done when I was your age, but I have sat where you have sat. And I did things in my youth and in my military, and before I joined the military, that the military held me accountable for when I joined the military. I had volunteered for this very prestigious unit, HMX, back when I first joined the military, and was denied because of things that I had done and how I acted in school and prior serving in the military. And that kept me from being able to obtain the clearances needed for presidential duty at the time. It took me 20 years of teamwork, brotherhood, and accountability to have the opportunity to then lead that organization. I tell you this, one, because your actions can affect what you do in the future. And two, you can also overcome those actions and still achieve success. I told this to every young Marine that was denied the chance to serve on presidential duty and that I too was denied that opportunity. To never give up, and was now leading that very organization that I thought out of reach when I was 18 years old. While at HMX 1, I traveled all over the world with President Trump. Wherever the president goes, there's always a helicopter or several for his use. It was an amazing experience to have a front row seat riding on the coattails of history as it was being made. But that opportunity became another. It was my final duty station and where I retired from as a senior enlisted advisor from the White House Military Office, not new to the government. It was at the White House that I had the opportunity to lead over 3,100 Joint Service members and civilians of all branches of service. This was my greatest and culminating achievement, not because I was working at the White House, but because I had the opportunity to work with the best of all branches, the Army, Navy, Marine Corps, Air Force, Space Force, Coast Guard, that provided direct support to the President in his three constitutional roles as Commander-in-Chief, Head of State, and Chief Executive. If John Allen from a rural community in East Texas can achieve this level of success in the military, so can each and every one of you. Whatever it is you do, strive to be the best at it. During my time overseas with Special Operations and serving at the pleasure of the President, it was not without sacrifice. I missed a lot by not being home like every veteran here today has. All my sacrifices of missing out on family events and holidays is in no comparison to the ultimate sacrifice that so many of my fellow service members have made by giving their lives to freedom for our country. And the truth is that all veterans pay with their lives. Some pay all at once, while others pay over a lifetime. It is my opinion that the uniform does not make you a hero, but the sacrifice that is made while wearing the uniform, and unfortunately, long after that uniform is taken off. All veterans have protected our democracy, our freedoms, our way of life. Today, we honor and we thank them. And tomorrow, we must continue to honor them. They have given us a chance to live in freedom today and the opportunity to look forward to tomorrow. They have given us every day and have protected our freedom. We must honor them as you all are doing here today. The best way to honor a veteran is to take an active part in maintaining our freedom to America. We must teach our future generations that it means to be American, what it means to be an American. Without veterans, we wouldn't be here today. Without you, we wouldn't be able to reach where we could be tomorrow. Thank you all again for being patriots, loving our country, our flag, and taking the time to honor our veterans today. May God bless them, you all here at Cayuga ISD and the United States of America. Thank you.
These brave ones raised a hand. No hesitation held them back. They were proud to take a stand. They left their friends and family. They gave up normal life to serve their country and their God. They plowed into the strife. They fought for freedom and for peace on strange and foreign shores. Some lost new friends, some lost their lives in long and brutal wars. Other veterans answered a call to support the ones who fought. Their country had requirements for the essential skills they brought. We salute every one of them, the noble and the brave, the ones still with us here today, and the ones who rest in the grave. So here's to our country's heroes. They are cut above the rest. Let's give the honor that is due to our country's very best. Veteran, you are one of our country's best. We honor you as our noble and brave. Whit Jenkins will now announce the veterans we have with us today. When he calls your name, please stand.
Please hold your applause to the end. Jay Thompson, Army. John Lynch, Navy. Todd Sharp, Army. Natalie Allen, Marines. John Allen, Marines. Mark Franks, Army. Bruce Grimsley, Air Force. Chester Meek, Navy. James Smith, Air Force. Ashley Rogers, Army. Joe Mattel, Navy. Ted Mattel, Navy. Dalton Reagan, Marines. George Douglas, Army. Nelson and Judy Kennedy, Army. Jerry Lawson, Army. Josh Griffin, Navy. Bob Renko, Air Force. Marcus Lawson, Navy. Shaquille Jenkins, Army. Sam Walsell, Navy. Drew Mountford, Marine Corps. Wanda Johnson, Air Force. Candace Gaylord, Air Force. Callie Richardson, Army. Chelsea Green, Air Force.
Now each color was fine. Oh, I'm I'm standing over arm with allegiance at time. His dad pulled out a box with a folded flag. Said, trust me, son, it means way more than that. It's more than flags, stars, and stripes. You hit ways for a war to die.
American, where at least I know I'm free. And from the lakes of Minnesota to the hills of Tennessee, across the plains of Texas, from the sea to shining sea, from Detroit down to Houston, and New York to LA. Well, it's right in every American heart, and it's time we stand and say,
as we end today's program, let us at Cayuga ISD always remember the veterans of the past, present, and future. Let us continue to keep our servicemen and women in our thoughts and prayers. May we never, as American citizens, take for granted our freedom and liberties that were won at a courageous cost. Faculty, guests, and students, thank you for coming to our program. We would like to invite our veterans to a reception in their honor at the high school library immediately following the program. As we conclude, please stand our nation's colors.
All right, thank y'all for coming. Y'all are dismissed. Thank you.